Welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are all doing awesome. I hope you guys are having an awesome day, week, weekend, whenever you watch this. Last week was a little bit hard for me to film. It was so crazy busy, the past 2 weeks that I didn't really have a chance to sit and film and get a lot of things out for you guys. I think I got one video out and I'm sorry, I tried at least to get two. But things should slow down now and I should be able to have a lot of good videos, a lot of goodies coming up for you guys. So what I want to share with you guys today are the new Makeup Geek foiled eyeshadows. I just received these today. I couldn't wait for the USPS guy to get here so that I can play with these babies. So along with my eyeshadows, I got a Z palette and this foundation stippling brush. I've been dying to try this out. I haven't used it yet, but I only use my, well, for the most part, I only use my Sigma F80. That's like my favorite, but I've seen a lot of people really like this one. And since the Morphe one that I want to purchase is out of stock, I went ahead and picked this one up so I can try this one for now. So I'll let you guys know how this goes. Of course, the eyeshadows are the star of this video, but isn't this the cutest Z palette that you guys have ever freaking seen? Oh my God. I am so obsessed with it. I saw it online and I was like, this screams like 90s Saved by the Bell to me. I was like, I need this palette. I just want this palette. And all these shadows were not gonna fit in my big Z palette that I have right now. So I went ahead and I picked this one up. This one was 20 bucks on Makeup Geek. I am like so in love with it. It's so freaking cute. Oh, I love it so much. But now to get into the beauties of this, and I will be showing you guys swatches of these eyeshadows. I'm gonna show you guys like a little clip of a pan and the eyeshadows, but they are so beautiful. And it's the eyeshadows that I'm wearing on my eyes today. I used four of them because I used four of them because I couldn't resist. Like, I just wanted to try all of them. And yeah, so these eyeshadows retail for $9.99, and that is rather expensive because most of the Makeup Geek eyeshadows are just $5.99 or $6.99, I believe, if I'm not mistaken. But these are pretty much like pressed pigments. They are foiled, so you don't really need any Fix Plus or anything like that. But because of the quality and because of the intensity of the pigment, I'm sure that it costs Makeup Geek a little bit more to formulate these, which is why they retail for a higher price. A little bit of this does go a very long way. If you apply them with your finger, you will get the complete concentration of the pigment. It doesn't mean that you will not get the same pigmentation with an eye brush. However, I do find that the pigment is just bam, intense right on once you use your fingers. But it does apply nicely either way. Like, they're just beautiful, beautiful shadows. I am so happy that I purchased these. I got all 10 for, I think, $89.99, and you're technically getting one free because there's 10 shadows. I mean, I eventually wanted them all, so I just figured to like go ahead and just one last splurge. And the texture of these, they're like, they're kind of, I don't know how to explain them. They're very soft and they're very like buttery when you swatch them. And texture wise, they kind of remind me, they're like a powdery, creamy. They feel sometimes a little wet to the touch, but they're not a cream. If any of you guys have touched the ColourPop eyeshadows, they kind of remind me texture wise of that, but they're not as like spongy. It's a cool texture, so I like it. So yeah, let's get started, and I am going to just go in the order that I have them here in my little Z palette. This is what they all look like. They're absolutely gorgeous, but I will show you guys one by one. So the first one that I'm going to talk about is the one that I have in my inner corner today. It's the one I'm using as an inner corner highlight, and this is called Magic Act. This is just a very beautiful gold color. It's like a pale gold with, I want to say, a little hint of like very light rose. I don't know, that's what I see in the pan. Swatch, you don't see that much, but that's just what I get. Maybe it's just lighting in my room. But it is a beautiful, beautiful color. It is super buttery, super pigmented, and this is a beautiful color that you can use all over the lid. You can use it like I'm using it as an inner corner highlight. There's just so many different ways to wear this because it's not just like, it's not a crazy gold where it's too much. It's a gold that you can use as a pop of color, as just a day-to-day look. It's just very universal, and I feel like this will complement pretty much every single skin tone. It's just a beautiful shade. The next shade is called In the Spotlight. This is just a beautiful like rose gold, but I see like a orange undertone to it. Like it just gives it a lot of dimension. It is absolutely stunning. When swatched, I feel like this is another shade where you can use all over the lid as a pop of color. This one and Magic Act are very, very universal. I feel like they're gonna look gorgeous on many different people. And it's just, oh my god, they have such like, they're so beautiful. They're just beautiful. More, it's like an orangey burnt coral kind of undertone, and it is absolutely beautiful. I haven't used this one yet, but it is so buttery and smooth when swatched that I definitely think that a lot of people are really going to enjoy this because it's not too much or too crazy where you're gonna be scared to ever use it. I feel like you can use this on a daily basis. The third one I have here is called Grandstand. It's an absolutely beautiful, beautiful bronze shade. I absolutely love shades like these. Like they're so, so beautiful. Again, like all like the first three, I just feel like these are very wearable shades. These are very, like depending what type of look you want, if you want a more fresh, bright eye look, I would go for the Magic Act all over the lid, just deepen it out a little bit. If you want more of like a romantic, soft, like just a beautiful romantic look, definitely the In the Spotlight would be one. This Grandstand to me is, it's more like sultry, more like sexy. It's just a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful shade. This next shade is like the taupier, more purpley version of Grandstand, and it is a beautiful taupey purple. Like a taupey brown purple. It's a little difficult for me to describe. It is absolutely beautiful. These are like swatch like a dream. The pigment is unreal in these shadows, like they're unreal. This one is just another beautiful color that I feel like would be so pretty for so many things, under the lash line, to deepen out a look. It's just a beautiful like taupey brown purpley light. I love it. If you guys would feel the texture of these shadows, it's unreal. Like I can't explain it. I just really can't. Feels so buttery. I stabbed one. I think in the clip of this next eyeshadow, I'm gonna show you guys like how squishy it is because I kind of dipped my nail into it and kind of stabbed it a little. So I pressed it back in and it's like, that's, I guess you can see a little bit how like it kind of marks your fingerprint in it. It's like a cream and powder like morphed into one. So yeah. So yeah, so this next one is in the color Showtime. This reminds me a lot of Bitten and Burlesque from Makeup Geek, and it is to me the one that I feel has the least sheen and a little bit more shimmer. Still absolutely buttery and smooth. The sheen isn't as like intense as the other ones. I feel like you can see a little bit more shimmer in it than the sheen, but it is extremely, extremely, extremely pigmented. I feel like you can use this shade just the same way that you would use those Bitten, that Bitten and Burlesque. Like it's, if you want like a cranberry burgundy smoky eye, or if you want to use it under the lower lash line to deepen out a look, or just kind of maybe all over the lid if you want, why not? The next two eyeshadows, literally like they give me life. Like my first video here on YouTube, I used the Vegas Lights pigment to create my look. And I think I've mentioned it a few times that Vegas Lights and Utopia from Makeup Geek are my favorite pigments that they have. It is just such a beautiful, coppery, intense eyeshadow. And once I saw Marlena do her swatches on her channel, the moment she put this eyeshadow up, I was like, Vegas Lights. Oh my god, they have Vegas Lights in a pan form. I need this. Like, if there was any that I was going to get, it was definitely going to be this one. And I'm actually going to show you guys like a live swatch of this because this is, it's literally Vegas Lights in a pressed eyeshadow, pressed pigment. It's unbelievable. Okay, so this, seriously, like, oh my god. Do you guys see the intensity? That is one freaking swatch and I'm literally using that same swatch to spread the color everywhere. It is so unbelievably pigmented. I seriously could not understand how it was possible to get such... Look at this. Oh my god, it's so pretty. Oh my god. So this is what I put on my lower lash line today. I could not resist that. Like, I couldn't resist not using this color. I had to use this eyeshadow. So I didn't use it as intensely on my lower lash line. I kind of stamped it a little bit with a flat definer brush and then used a pencil brush and buffed a little bit more in just to kind of give a light pop of color down there. It's just like, oh my god. I will use this in every way, shape, or form possible to use an eyeshadow. Like, this is the most beautiful thing in this entire planet. It's just a true, true copper, intense copper, burnt copper orange vibe. It's just perfection. It is the most beautiful. I don't even think I've told you guys the name. It's called Flamethrower, and that name suits it perfectly because it looks like freaking gorgeous fire with beautiful pigmented sheen. It's just the most beautiful thing I have ever seen in my life. Now this next one is the one that I have, like, I kind of stamped it on the center of my eyelids, and this eyeshadow is just beautiful. I have, like, found myself drawn to these type of eyeshadows lately, when normally it just wasn't, like, a thing for me. This one is called Jester, and this is a beautiful green with a gorgeous, gorgeous gold undertone. It looks like a green duochrome gold. Like, it's that intense. They feel so smooth. Oh my god, you guys, I need to shut up. The fact that it has green undertones makes it a very wearable green eyeshadow, and it will complement a lot of eye colors. I have green eyes, so I feel like sometimes green can just kind of blend in with my eyes, but colors like this, because of the gold, look at that gold. Because of the gold, I feel like it really brings out any yellow or gold that I have in my eyes, and it just kind of, it still helps make my eyes stand out. I feel like for brown eyes, this is going to look stunning, and it's just, oh my god, it's absolutely beautiful. So my camera died, and I'm pretty sure angle, lighting, everything might be a little different right now, so I am very sorry for that. I seriously need to invest in a second battery. So the last shadow that I was talking about was this green gold Jester. It's so beautiful. I don't understand how it's possible to have this much pigmentation and such a smooth formula in eyeshadows. Like, I don't get it. I don't get it. This next eyeshadow, I feel like it's a really special eyeshadow because all the earnings and the proceeds will go to Batten's disease. I feel like that is a very, very sweet of Marlena to do that. And I feel like this is just, it's just for a good cause. Not only are you getting a very beautiful eyeshadow, but you're also donating. Like, it's a win-win, I think. This next shade is in memory of one of the girls that Marlena was saying on her channel that she knows the family, and she passed away from Batten's disease, and they named this in memory of her because her favorite color was purple. So it's just very sweet. This eyeshadow is purple, but it's very iridescent. It has a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful sheen. I feel that on darker complexions, this eyeshadow is going to be breathtaking. For me, I feel like you see more iridescent than you see purple, but I swatched it on my friend who is of darker complexion, and this, like, it just went on so, like, I saw, like, I was jealous a little because I swatched on her, like, obviously smooth as butter because that's how they all feel, but with such vibrancy. This is a beautiful shade, I feel, to put all over the lid. It has a beautiful, beautiful iridescence to it. It's like a purple pinky kind of iridescence. It's gorgeous. So then the next shade, it's a beautiful deep blue, but it has almost like a hint of like a purpley sheen to it. I'm really excited to try this one on the lid because I feel like sometimes dark colors like this, they end up showing more black than like the actual vibrancy of the color, and I'm really excited to see how this is going to show up on the lid. It does swatch a little differently than what it looks like in the pan. I feel like it swatches, leans a little bit more like blue purple instead of that navy purple, but nonetheless it's a beautiful, beautiful color. And last but not least is the shade that I have all over my lid. I kind of mixed in this one with Jester. I put this one, this is called Houdini, and I put it all over the lid, and then I packed on a little bit of Gesture in the middle, and then I packed on a little bit more of Houdini just to kind of give it more depth and more definition, but I didn't want more of the Houdini to stick out instead of the Gesture. It's a beautiful, like, very deep teal color. This is one of the ones that is super, super rich in pigmentation. Like, they're all extremely pigmented, but I feel like some outdo the others and some look that much more vibrant when swatched or when applied. And this is definitely one that I wanted to try out because I generally, like, I love these colors, but I don't really do a lot with them when I have them. So I wanted to try this one out first. It is a beautiful, beautiful, just deep, deep metallic-y teal. It's just a beautiful, beautiful sheen. Like, as you guys can see, these eyeshadows are beautiful. They are absolutely beautiful, extremely, extremely pigmented. I feel like there is a variety of colors here for what everyone likes or what everyone would have preference to. I'm pretty sure she's working on more. I think so. But so far, this is what she's put out, and they're absolutely brilliant. Amazing eyeshadows, amazing quality, amazing pigmentation, amazing formula. Makeup Geek really outdid themselves with this. It's insane, and the price is crazy to me. It's just the beautiful, beautiful, beautiful eyeshadows. I feel like if you guys want to invest in some of these, I would definitely try it out. If you want the whole thing, put it on your Christmas list because it is really worth it, and you're getting one free pretty much. I will have a tutorial coming up, this tutorial with this eye look using the shadows, and well, pretty much using all Makeup Geek shadows, but I did incorporate four of them in the look. If you can't afford all of them, then pick your favorite one. But my top, like, is definitely Flamethrower and Gesture. I think these are gorgeous, like pops of color, gorgeous, fun, crazy colors. And then these four right here are amazing. Definitely this one, which I think is Grandstand, and Magic Act are beautiful. And then I love this one because I feel like it's so unique. This one's in the spotlight because it has that burnt orangey coral color under it, and I just feel like it's very unique. And also the one for Batten's disease, I feel like it's a beautiful cause and it's a beautiful way to give, especially in this season. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this like little mini review slash first impressions of this. Well, it's not really first impressions, I guess, like a mini first review. You guys get it, right? Yeah. I will link down below the bundle that I used to get all of them. I will be posting up the tutorial for this look more than likely on Friday. Hope you guys are excited for that. Yeah, this is the end of this video. I would love so much if you guys subscribe and join me for more. Yeah, no, I'm so cheesy. I hope you guys have an awesome week, and I will see you guys really, really soon. Bye.